And what about Gehazi? Gehazi also slandered a bit. He said that his master wanted the money back, and it's not true. But also, Gehazi failed to appreciate the potential that he had, potential to be like Elijah. See, there was Elijah the prophet. His student was Elisha the prophet. And the next prophet was supposed to be Gehazi. But we never heard of Gehazi, did we? Because he becomes a leper. But he had tremendous potential. As a matter of fact, later on, rabbis say that he was one of the four people in the Haftorah this week who are going to save the Jewish people, even from their lepers, even as they were lepers. They would save the Jewish people in the days of Elisha. Such potential. The next Elijah the prophet. Lost because of bribery. Lost because he didn't appreciate who he was and his master, his teacher, Elisha. Perhaps he should have appreciated more who he was too. There is a notion that had Elisha been more forgiving of Gehazi, the Midrash says, maybe Gehazi could have become something. Maybe Gehazi could have become the next Elijah the prophet, and Gehazi would come visit us at our seders and our brises. Finally, Uzziyahu. Uzziyahu, the king Uzziyahu, was a wonderful king. So pious, so holy. But he thought he was something that he wasn't. He thought he was a Kohen too. He thought, after all, I'm the leader of a Jewish renaissance. I'm the great rabbi, the great religious leader. And the Kohanim said, no, there are different roles in Judaism. There are Kohanim and there are kings. You have a tremendous role to play in the future of the Torah in Israel. But not to usurp the role of the Kohanim. There are distinct roles for each of us to play. Don't cross over. Appreciate who you are. Like Miriam, know your place. And he didn't. And he got leprosy. The overarching theory of the notion of leprosy is the notion that we need to know who we are. This parsha this week is not about some blotches, red blotches and white blotches. This parsha this week is about looking at the inner you to discover and know who you really are. The great mystic, the Ari, says that, you know what a nega is? You know what it means when a person is blemished? It's a histalkut koach alyon. That ancient plague was a sign that the koach alyon, the inner elevated self, was lost. In the words of the Kuzari, the great medieval poet, philosopher, histalkut ha'or ha'eloki. It's a loss of the great divine light that lies within each of us. The potential for our souls. When our outsides are not looking so hot, it can be a reflection of our lack of inner awe, of inner aura that should shine forth. Every person, whether blessed with a beautiful face or otherwise, no matter what anyone says, they should shine with an or haloki, with a divine light. Gossip against others is losing sight of the mark, of the vision, that I have a great inner potential. And I need to work on my flaws, not other people's flaws, my flaws. And with that, the great inner potential can come out. With this, we can understand how the leper is told to heal himself. What's the tikkun? What's the solution to a leper? Number one, michutz lamachaneh. Go outside the camp, leper. You don't understand the relationship between you and others. Perhaps you're greater than they are. Perhaps you're the same as they are. Perhaps you have the same flaws that you see in others. You need to reassess the relationship between you and others, your flaws and the flaws of those around you. You can spend your whole life dedicated and devoted to how the other person should do better. Ah, what a waste. You could have spent the same time making yourself better, and that would have been more productive. What's the tikkun? What's the fixing in Parshat Tazria Metzora? Parshat Metzora, it says, we take the leper and we sprinkle some blood on his right earlobe, on his right thumb, on the right big toe. Who else has this type of ceremony? The Kohen. When the Kohanim were inaugurated and anointed in the previous parsha, parshiot. You know how we anoint them? We sprinkle blood on their right earlobe and their right thumb and their right big toe. Because we want a total transformation of what they're hearing, what they're saying, of what they're doing, of where they're going. We want a total makeover. We want to make this plain person into a Kohen. In this case, we want to take this person and transform his potential into reality. And this can explain a fascinating Gemara at the end of Sota. Gemara there says that the Mishnah says that once Rebbe died, once the great sage who wrote the Mishnah, organized the Mishnah, died, there were no more real modest people, anava, of anavim. There weren't any yurechet, those who really feared God. Come to rabbis in the Talmud and say something very strange. Rav Yosef said, when you're learning this Mishnah, erase that line that says that there are no more people who are modest. Because after all, there's me, said Rav Yosef. I'm modest. So when Rebbe died, anava was not lost. And Rav Nachman says, don't read that line in the Mishnah that says there are no more people who fear God. De'ika ana. There's always me. Don't forget about me. How could the rabbis say this? How could two rabbis boast of their modesty of all things and of their piety? How is it possible? And the answer is that Jewish modesty doesn't mean to not appreciate who we are. On the contrary, Jewish modesty is to understand who I am in relation to others, in relation to my own flaws, in relation to my potential. And when I appreciate that, I can indeed boast. I understand who I am. And ha'ika ana, I am what I am. Our goal is to appreciate, as these rabbis did, what our great potential is, who we are, our relationship to others, that we should be able to move freely in the camp, to appreciate that the flaws in others are only for us to see a mirror of the difficulties we face ourselves. And when we appreciate what flaws we need to work on, we'll have a holier camp. We'll appreciate the inner beauty, our Or Haloki, our inner divine spirit much more. And we will be blessed to really appreciate our potential, so that one day, maybe we too can say, as the rabbis of old said, Ha'ika ana, I appreciate who I am. I've worked on myself. And now I can say in all honesty, I have reached my potential. What is leprosy? Leprosy is not a bunch of blotches. What are these parshiot this week? It's not just a lot of mumbo jumbo. These parshiot are about the notion of who am I? What is my inner potential? And what are the relationship between me and those around me? The flaws of those around me and myself. And as I come to appreciate this more deeply and more profoundly, I will become a new person. They'll come and they'll sprinkle blood on my ear and my thumb and my feet. And hopefully, what I say and what I hear will transform into my ultimate potential. What I do with my hands will transform into its ultimate potential. And where I go with my feet will transform into its ultimate potential. That I will have the Or Haloki, the great light, will shine forth. Thank you for joining us today. Please join us next week again, each Monday, for the live broadcast and the archive on youtube.com/asbmemphis. Next week, we'll be speaking about Jewish aesthetics. Thank you.